Pundit! Back at it again, man. We back at it again. Man, I have a questionnaire. It isn't funny, but it's kind of funny, man, because me and the guy at work, man, we was noticing specific things about females and females in general, man. You know, he was saying, hey, dude, where are the black sisters at? Where are the sisters at, period? And, dude, I'm like, hey, man, I don't know, dog. You know, I'm being real. I do not know. I've been listening to certain people say things and stuff like that. It's like people are starting to say, hey, when you get so high in your career or in the field that you are in, the less sisters you will see. And I'm starting to think that there is a little bit of truth to that. Because, man, we were looking at things yesterday and we could not find a sister nowhere. We were looking. We were looking hard. We were looking high. We were looking low. There were no sisters to be found, man. So what is it for a brother to do if he's seeking out a sister, but there are no sisters in his realm, you know? So I was asking him, man, you know, do you go to the club? He's like, motherfucker, it's COVID going on. You know, can't nobody go to a club right now. So where can you find a sister at? Man, I don't know. You know, that's that, man, I can't answer that goddamn question for you. But here's what I do know, that the demographics are in the males arena. It's in the male side of the court. That's where the ball is. Because demographically, they say that there are 47 women to one man. 47 women. So what the fuck does that say? I don't probably even know 47 people total. Not even talking about goddamn women. So that's a whole lot, man. That's a whole lot of goddamn women to one man. Really and truly, that is a whole lot of women to one goddamn man, man. That's enough to make you say, hey, I'm going to have to motherfucker take a vacation from dealing with these motherfuckers for a minute, you know. And then I think that the numbers could be higher than that, because when you look at motherfuckers that's gay, motherfuckers that's locked up in jail, motherfuckers that are married, motherfuckers that are in different relationships and the chicks don't know it, motherfucker, he's in this relationship and you know you don't know it, but he know it, man. The numbers is probably around about 52. It's probably a damn extra motherfucker 5 or so, you know. So I don't know, man, but I was looking at him and I'm thinking, dude, you know what, you got a point here. And I think everybody else kind of have a point too, man. We may have to do a good systematic motherfucking survey just to see, man, because where are the sisters at? Goddamn, this motherfucker had my wheels turning so hard. I went to the grocery store yesterday and I was looking for sisters in the grocery store. Man, I didn't see number one in the I went to two different grocery stores, not because I was looking for sisters, but I had to grab some things, so I had to go to two different grocery stores. And in the grocery stores, the only thing I saw was Hispanic chicks and white chicks, which nothing is wrong with that. I used to tell motherfuckers when I was coming up, you know, and everything, my dick is an equal opportunity rider. It's for white girls, black girls, Hispanic girls, Puerto Rican girls, Brazil. Look, I like who like me, you know, and that's how I've always been. I don't technically have a preference, man. Just have pretty feet, pretty hands, and be clean. You dig what I'm saying? And have some business about yourself, man. You gotta have business about yourself. Because pussy only gets you so far. Pussy will get you fucked probably 2-3 times, then the motherfucker kick you to the curb. Like, what are you bringing to the table? You got to be bringing something to the table besides your motherfucker appetite and your feet to put up under the table. What are you bringing to the table? You know, motherfuckers used to fall for that pussy line. Oh, pussy, yeah, man. But now motherfuckers like, man, no, I'd rather have money than pussy. Because if I got money, I could order and get the pussy that I want to. I could say I want 36, 24, 36 and get that motherfucker sent here. I could say I want caramel, butter pecan. I could say I want black. I could say I want white. So, you know, motherfuckers rather have money than have pussy, man. You dig what I'm saying? So But I was looking, I was like, God damn, he kind of have a point here, man, because this shit is crazy, man. It is crazy, but I'm telling you guys, man, you gotta do your homework. I don't know. I can't answer that question, man. You dig what I'm saying? But what I do know, I've been dealing with females for a long, long, long time. Man, I was into pimping when I was motherfucking 15, 16 years old, man. And stuff. And that's something that we'll get into, you know, later. I will withhold the names of the innocent to protect the innocent and everything, man. But that's something totally motherfucking different, man. They call that shit human trafficking now and shit, man. You know what I'm saying? But you can't human traffic a lady that asks you to pimp her. That's the only thing I can say about that. So, you know, hey, man, you gotta leave these hoes alone. Hoes got whole things to do, and don't hold a hoe up, man. You know what I'm saying? She could want to be a hoe. Some females have a high sex drive. So what? Let them do what the fuck they want to do, man. Why y'all try to govern everybody? And why y'all try to shun people? Hey, if you got a high sex drive and she don't, then guess what, man? It's her prerogative. You know what I'm saying? If she want to give that shit away on a silver platter, she want to give it away out of her goddamn hand. Let her do what the fuck she want to, motherfucker do, man. But I'm sitting back and I'm watching this shit now. I'm like, man, where are my sisters at, man? Are y'all at the house, or, I mean, what the fuck is going on, man? You know, and it trips me out, man, because I sit and I listen to, chicks talk and stuff, and I be thinking, man, if you are in your 30, if you are over 35 and nobody has ever proposed to you or asked you to marry them or come through with a ring, you have got to you got to do some self-evaluation, man. You got to try to figure out, why the fuck am I attracting the wrong dude? Or you got to try to figure out, why the fuck I can't get nobody? Now, certain people, they are business-oriented, goal-oriented, career-oriented, and they don't want nobody. You know what I'm saying? They might just want some dick or want some AAA, AA batteries for their little motherfucking sword or whatever, man. But just as far as physically having a man all the time, they don't want that shit. They might want your man, you dig what I'm saying, for a little bit of time, then you could, hey, get the motherfucker back, man. You know, but I don't get it, man. You know, and it's kind of like, so what is a chick to do when she's at that age and her field is shrinking? Her field is shrinking, because if you are 35, the guys that are 35, they might be married, or they might be engaged, or they probably have kids, or they just saying, hey, man, I ain't getting ready to fuck with a chick on that level. You know, I'll fucking run around town with your mate, take you on a couple of trips with me and shit, but I'm not getting ready to be, you know, trying to tie myself down and get married to you or nothing like that. So with that being said, what is a chick to do? Does she, A, lower her standards, or does she, be, you know, keep her standards the way it is and just keep on rocking by herself until she find her somebody that she really want to be with? You dig what I'm saying? So it's going to be different, man, because a whole lot of ladies, they're like, man, you know what, I'm gonna lower my standards and go with this one. Or, man, it's not a fucking fairy tale. You're not gonna find a perfect lady, you're not gonna find a perfect man. You're not going to find a perfect company to work for. You just got to make the best of the situation that you're in. And don't cheat yourself. Don't be in the meantime and in between time to something better come along, because you could actually be cheating yourself out of what you have right now. That shit, the good shit can be up under your nose, but you overlooking it, looking out into the field and shit, man. So that's kind of like, it's a question that I think ladies that's 35 on up need to ask themselves, man. But it's okay, shit. My motherfucking mom, she got divorced, ain't never got back married. She said, I ain't want to fuck with no motherfucker like that. So, I mean, it's okay, man. But I'm just asking for the females that really, really, really want to, you know, figure out, why ain't nobody proposed to me? Why all these other ladies, they got dudes and I don't? I was just sitting back listening like, shit, I don't know. Maybe you fucking them too early. Maybe you fucking the wrong dude. You know, I mean, dudes, man, we're strange creatures, man. You know, we will hang around and hang around and hang around till you finally let us hit that ass, and then, shit, we gone in. Shit, we won. 1-0. Baseball game. It's over with. We won. We might hang around and hit it 2, 3, 4 times, then we gone like, man, that shit was not worth motherfucker waiting on. Somebody the motherfucker fooled her. She been fucking around with a couple of these simp ass motherfuckers thinking that, you know, her shit is lit, and it ain't, man. Motherfucker doused her with water. There's no fire in that place right there. There's no fire in the fire pit, in the fireplace, man. She think it is, but it ain't. You know, so I don't know, man. But females, that's something that you guys need to ask yourself. You got to do some self-motherfucking cleaning. Like, not cleaning your pussy or your body. Just self-cleaning of like, spring cleaning. Saying, hey, what is it about me that I'm not attracting the right person? Or, hey, what is it about me that is just not clicking, that I'm not where I'm at? You know, because people, you know, they kind of put timelines. Hey, this is when I want this. This is when I want that. Like, you making up a goddamn story. And the only thing you need to do is just nab a brother. Huh? Come on in. You the man that I want to have all this with. You know, it's crazy, man. They kind of live a fairy tale and we don't. You know, they live a fairy tale, we live a pimp tale. They live a fairy tale, we live a player tale. So it's crazy, man. But that's some questions that everybody need to pretty much ask themselves, man. Like I say, pundit, nobody's listening, man. But you need to listen to me, because I'm an expert on plenty of men and motherfucking topics, man. And relationships and females are one of them, man. You guys be good, be safe today, and I will holler later, people.